Hello there. I'm trying to do a video showing how to solve the wiring harness for the three program setup that Digital Control Service provides and offers. What he does is he installs three different programs on your actual ECM, and it comes with this switch and a couple cables that you have to wire, you know, directly to the ECM harness. So the first thing you gotta do is install the switch. This comes off. So what you gotta do is do this whole 7/8 inch big, and then you just have to mark these two holes. I don't know if this is the proper way to install this switch. That's the way I did it. Okay guys, I'm here underneath my truck. This is the actual harness that we were talking about earlier. And what you need to do, this is on the on the firewall side, on your right side of the ECM. These two cables right here. Like in my case, I already have two existing cables. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut them, which is this pin right here and this pin right here. The first one from the bottom to the top, and the third one on the right lane. I'm gonna show you the instructions where he's pointing at those two right there. The first one from the bottom to the top is the black wire, and the third one is for the red wire. Okay guys, so this is a Freightliner FLD120. And this is my harness, as you can see here. And I decided to do the hole to run the wire here, there. Really close, so I can run it along the wire harness. I put a little piece of PVC just to protect, so it doesn't rub against the firewall. Hey guys, so here's another step you have to do. I recommend you to do, just put some wire cover, you know, just put on wire cover. So I already drawn my cable, insert cover all the way to the ground. You need to hook this blue wire to a ground. I'm gonna hook it up here because this goes to the column and the column goes to the chassis. And as you can see, I already had before a ground here, which it was for my fog lights. So I'm gonna hook it up there. I'm gonna run the other cables through the firewall. Wire already all the way down. Here it is, all covered with, you know, some wire protector. It goes here. I run it underneath the intake manifold. It goes here and it goes down up to there. Okay, so the next step is just to hook up the wires. Should be almost ready. Okay guys, so now I'm doing the connection here. As you can see, I already did one. The red one goes on the top one, which is the third pin right here. And the black one goes here. I put a heat shrink in these connections that they provide. All you have to do is push the cable through here and it won't come off, and then you just have to push the other day here, and then you have it like that. What I did, I just put the heat shrink on top and shrink it. I haven't shrink it all the way, but that's the way it's gonna be. Okay, here is the black one without the heat shrink. As you can see, just the connection provided. Just push the cable on both ends, then it won't come off. Test it a couple times, pull it kind of hard, just to make sure it won't come off. And then what you do, put your heat shrink on top, and you're almost done. Guys, so here's my finished
harness with a heat wrap. I'm gonna put some small tie rods here just for security purposes. And I put some heat wrap on the old cables, tape all around it. And the only thing I need to do now is just to hook up the ECM.
Okay guys, I'm almost done. Don't forget to seal your hole where you put your cable or silicone. This is the one I use because it's really easy to use. You don't need a gun or anything. You just, you know, push it in. You're ready to put some silicone in it. I use it for everything. Even to hold the lights. When you put lights on the chrome trim and they don't fit properly and they fall off with all the bouncing and stuff. This is the good stuff. So you seal it. I'm gonna put some around the hole here and I'm almost done. Almost ready to test it. It's all done, all finished. Let's give it a try. All right. It seems so good, I won't be able to give it a try. I guess until I go out to work, so at least it seems it's working. Difference now that it's not moving. I guess I'm gonna have to give it a try once I get a load and get back to work. So thanks for watching.